In the automotive world, performance cars are separated into three main categories: a sports car, supercars, and hypercars. What is the difference between these three types of performance cars? Well, you're gonna find out in this video. And if that sounds interesting, let's get to it. And if you're new to this channel, my name is Victor Aldo, and on this channel, you're gonna learn more about cars with videos like reviews, in-depth looks, and other cool stuff. And if you love cars and you wanna know more about cars, then I suggest hitting that subscribe button and joining the YouTube family. Now, what is a sports car? The definition of a sports car may change depending on who you talk to, but generally speaking, there's some specific traits that define this category. Typically, a sports car will be small, lightweight, aerodynamic two-seater with high maneuverability and a low center of gravity compared to standard models. They make wonderful driver's cars, and they give you performance that you can actually exploit on a great road, rather than constantly thinking you need a racetrack. Sports cars are built to make driving fun and gratifying. Though it may have many similar attributes to supercars, they are more often affordable and have a lower top speed. However, their engine and performance engineering surpasses that of supercars in some cases. The sports car spectrum is arguably the broadest of all performance car category. A sports car can use rear, four, or even front wheel drive in rare applications on entry-level cars. It can house its engine either in the front, middle, or rear. But above all the tangible elements, a sports car must be fun and gratifying. And some examples of sports cars are a Toyota GT86, an Audi TT RS, and a Porsche 911 Carrera. And next up in the performance car category are supercars. Supercars reach well beyond the boundaries of sports cars in terms of speed, technology, design, and of course, price. Supercars are generally a little bit harder to handle than sports cars and usually have over 500 horsepower. In general, supercars aren't quite as usable as sports cars. That's because they're more focused on performance, but the prestige of owning one is worth it. Supercars nowadays, however, are more usable than they've ever been, with cars like the McLaren 720S being something you could potentially use as a daily driver. The majority of supercars are mid-engine. The same applies for transmission, as most of them nowadays use either a paddle shifter or direct shift gearbox. Supercars can be rear or four-wheel drive, but certainly not front-wheel drive. Examples of supercars can be a McLaren 720S, a Lamborghini Aventador SVJ, and a Ferrari 488 Pista. And the last in this category of performance cars are hypercars. Hypercars bend the boundaries of the impossible. Literally everything about hypercars is next level. They push the limits of physics as the absolute pinnacle of automotive engineering. They bring with them a level of performance that requires a professional to process and manage. Hypercars are capable of such alarming speeds that they're no longer approachable. They are sensitive to touch. They are out of this world expensive, with the majority of them being well over $1 million, and they can barely contain their speeds, making them nearly impractical for public roads. Like supercars, the majority of hypercars will be mid-engine, and they all feature a paddle shifter. They are the best of the best, expertly crafted, and when you step out of a hypercar, you're just happy to be alive. They are in an exclusive club, not just because of what they can do, but also because of how deep a person has to dig in order to purchase one. The very latest and revolutionary performance-enhancing technology usually debuts in an extreme form on a hypercar. And some examples of hypercars are a McLaren P1, a Ferrari LaFerrari, a Porsche 918 Spyder, a Koenigsegg Agera RS, and a Bugatti Chiron. And that's it for this video, guys. And what are your favorite sports cars, supercars, and hypercars? Put that in the comment section below. And what kind of videos you want to see me do on my channel, also comment down below. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you're new. And thank you guys for watching the video, and I will see you guys in the next video.